We also covered the antibodies topic, which is the immunoglobulin, which are written in short form as capital I and small g. These are protein molecules and they belong to the category of gamma globulins. There are types of antibodies, that is IgA, IgM, IgE, D, as well as G, and they are part of the humoral immune response. We learned that every antibody will have generally a Y-shaped structure in which there are two identical halves. Each half carry one heavy chain, one light chain, and these chains carry intra-chain as well as inter-chain disulfide bonds. And be careful with making this diagram because you always, many of you make wrong disulfide bonds. Each chain will have two region, one constant portion, one variable. Constant portion is almost same throughout all antibodies, but the variable part varies from antigen to antigen. That means it is something like lock and key. So variable portion is the one which attaches with the antigen. So that one would be variable. Rest all portion is almost similar. We learned that they are prepared by the plasma cells, that means B type of cells. And their rate of formation is 2000 molecules per second. We learned that IgG is the maximum one and IgM is the largest one. IgG is able to pass through the placenta and IgA is able to come out through the digestive tract in the form of copro and antibody. And IgE and IgD are present on the cell surfaces. Sorry, cell surfaces of the basophil mast cell, and D are present on the surface of B cell, blood and lymph. Their number is quite less compared to the other type of antibodies. IgE is responsible for allergic response, and IgD is to activate the B cell. IgA provides maximum immunity. And we learned even that when first time immune response take place, the first antibody to be formed by human body is the IgM. But later on, the number of IgG will increase manifold. And whenever second encounters happen, the production of G and M will be almost at the same time, but always the number of G will be more compared to the M. So first one to be formed and the largest one is the IgM. We discussed about how exactly the antibody and antigen interact with each other. So there is development of hydrogen bond and van der Waals bonds between the antigen and the antibodies. And this causes the breakdown of the antigen so that no infection occur. It may happen with the help of lysis of the microorganism by breakdown of its plasma membrane. It can happen with the neutralization of the toxin. It may happen by precipitation, by which the soluble antigens are made insoluble and they undergo precipitation, then quickly undergo phagocytosis. And even opsonization is possible, and even agglutination is possible. In all these methods, finally, the cells are the microorganisms are going to undergo phagocytosis. We covered the concept of immune response, that the moment immune system detects something, both humoral immune system and cell-mediated immune system, they both become active and they both provide the immunity to us. After this, we covered the topic of vaccination and immunization. We learned that immunization is a bigger concept in which immunity is given to a person. And it can be passively given or actively given. So if it is actively given immunization, then it is better called as the vaccination in which antibody provoking agents are given to a person, which is called as vaccine. So when vaccine is made, it can be the living but weakened microbe, also called as attenuated whole agent vaccine, or it can be killed microbe, example for that is called as the inactivated whole agent vaccine, or it could be just the toxins, inactivated toxins used, which are called as toxoids. Nowadays, even subunit vaccines are there. Genetically formed, biotechnology formed vaccines are there, for example, for the hepatitis B, and it is prepared in genetically modified yeasts. And then even conjugate vaccines and nucleic acid vaccines are coming up in research. we learned that the main thing in the immunization or vaccination concept is the property of memorization, because immunization can be given passively as well as actively, and in the case of vaccination, property of memory plays an important role. Vaccines can be first generation, second generation, third generation vaccines, depending upon whether they are conventionally prepared or genetically engineered prepared, or whether they are still under research, which are the synthetic vaccines. We discussed about immune system of human body, that it is made up of lymphoid organs, lymphoid tissues, lymphatic cells, as well as the antibodies. Cells and antibodies we have already covered in detail. So the lymphoid organs we discussed were of two types, primary and secondary. Primary lymphoid organs are those where maturation and specific antigen receptor development takes place on the surface of the cells, and those cells are basically B cells and T cells. Primary lymphoid organs are just two in number, bone marrow and thymus. All of them are synthesized in bone marrow, but some will migrate to thymus. So those which stay in the bone marrow and differentiate there are called as B cell, which migrate are called as the T cell. And then from the primary lymphoid organ, all of them are going to finally migrate through blood and lymph into the secondary lymphoid organs, which are into which the immune response develop. And these portions are lymph nodes, spleen, tonsils, Peyer's patches, and MALT. And we also understood that MALT is the mucosal associated lymphoid tissue, which constitutes 50% of total lymphoid tissue in the human body. It is found in the tract systems like respiratory, alimentary, urinogenital tracts. And we understood that Peyer's patches are present in the intestine. Tonsils form the covers the oro as well as the nasopharyngeal, those portions of the pharynx. And spleen is the largest lymphoid tissue. We even discussed the topic of allergies, that hypersensitivity of a person to some foreign substance, that substance is called as allergen. And then the symptoms basically are similar to some extent, because allergens come in contact with either skin or come in contact with the mucous membrane or otherwise the conjunctiva of eye. So accordingly, symptoms could be sneezing, watery eyes, runny nose, and difficulty in breathing.